I miss old wrestling. This wasn't a video that I was expecting to make. It wasn't one that I had written down and planned to make. But I found myself watching Survivor Series 2002 because Survivor Series 2020 is on Sunday night. I was like, you know, might as well go back and watch the greatest Survivor Series of all time to get myself hyped up for Survivor Series since WWE's done such a poor job in real life this year. But I'm watching Survivor Series 2002. And the overwhelming thought that's just going through my head over and over as I'm watching this show is, boy, I miss old wrestling. Just near enough everything about old wrestling. Now, whatever you want to quantify as old wrestling, just wrestling from either your childhood or, you know, 80s, 90s, 2000s, anytime. You know, it's not really like a specific little time period. It's just old wrestling because wrestling, in especially the past like 10 years, has just been so just polar opposite of what it became great upon. Like, what wrestling became great upon is writing that actually captivates a mainstream viewer and a casual viewer, star power, big stars in wrestling, matches that feel important and that aren't just moves for the sake of moves, moves with a reason, moves with psychology, with a story, and having these just, you know, long storylines that actually progress and there's reasons to care, all this kind of stuff. Having commentators who captivate you like Jim Ross and Jerry Lawler, having general managers, Bischoff, Stephanie, these kind of people, just the talent, like all of this kind of stuff. It encompasses what I like to call old wrestling. And really, as I'm sitting on my couch watching Survivor Series 2002, that's the only thing I can think about. Because I'm watching Survivor Series 2002, and I mean, where do you even begin? From the live musical performance of Saliva? Like, this isn't going to be a Survivor Series 2002 review, but it's just going to be me using examples from that show, you know, the best Survivor Series of all time, to really compare to what they do nowadays. So Survivor Series 2002, just casually, the first ever Elimination Chamber match. This giant, you know, debuting structure, WWE were debuting this big thing, this big structure to encompass the World Heavyweight Championship match where Triple H, Shawn Michaels, Chris Jericho, Kane, RVD, and Booker T all stepped inside of hell to compete for the World Heavyweight Championship. So we have that at Survivor Series 2002. And you think about, you know, all the hype and the buzz that was going into, you know, that at the time. Like, what is the Elimination Chamber? People were fascinated to see. It was Eric Bischoff's brainchild from hell, so to speak. So people really were fascinated to see it. It was a new, fresh concept. It was interesting. It was something that would make you buy a pay-per-view. You'd want to buy a pay-per-view and pay $50 just to see what these six guys did inside the Elimination Chamber, what the chamber looked like, you know, how Jim Ross and JR and Jerry Lawler, there we go, would sell the structure and all that. You wanted to see that kind of thing in MSG. But then you fast forward 18 years later to Survivor Series 2020, and there's basically no build to Survivor Series. The matches are there for the sake of it. We've got, I mean, our main event's like a big match, Reigns versus McIntyre, but I look at, I mean, the build to that match and the build to any of the matches. There's literally no build. And I'm looking at that and I'm comparing that to Survivor Series 2002 and this old wrestling where the writing was consistent. There was long-term, meaningful storylines. It wasn't like these long-term AEW storylines where basically nothing happens week to week and then they pass 3 months and then do something and everyone's like, oh my god, long-term storytelling, how amazing. Like, long-term storytelling back in the day, God, I sound old when I say that, but yeah, long-term storytelling back in the day with Austin and McMahon, actually meaningful, interesting, captivating stuff was happening every week. And it stayed that way for months and months and months and months and months. It's not like, as I said, with current day wrestling, where if they do a long-term storyline, like Seth Rollins, Rey Mysterio, Murphy, Aleah, like Aleister Black, Humberto Carrillo, Kevin Owens, they've all been involved in this kind of, this blender of a storyline for the past like 6 months. It's not like that where they do the same segment week in, week out, nothing progresses, you get sick of it after 3 weeks, you don't see it anymore. You're thinking to yourself as you're watching it, why am I doing this? It's just, it's a rerun of the past 6 weeks. You compare that to old wrestling, where they're doing new, interesting segments every week. You have your Austin McMahon types, your Rock and Triple H, Rock and the Corporation, that type of thing, and new, interesting segments happening every week. The story was getting fleshed out, so much so that because of the talent involved, because of how good the writing was, you had to see what was happening. You really needed to see what happened each week to week on these shows. But I look at current day wrestling and you don't see that. No one's, besides Roman Reigns, who's the best example of what old wrestling is in a modern day setting, besides Roman Reigns at the moment with the Tribal Chief, I look at the rest of wrestling and it's just like, it's nowhere near the same. And it hasn't changed for the better. As I said earlier in the video, the past decade or so for wrestling, I remember the Smokebusters said this, I forget when, but they said this once, like the past 10 to 15 years, what you've been watching as far as like WWE and wrestling in general, it isn't wrestling. Like wrestling, like what it's supposed to be is what, 80s, 90s, early 2000s. And then everything else, the last 10 to 15 years has just been this. I mean, the Smokebusters have described it as a weird experiment on the human race. I think that's fair enough. Like it's entertainment, kind of to an extent, but they don't really have a target audience. They're not going fully targeting 18 to 34. They're not fully targeting kids. They're not targeting teens. They're not really targeting families because families aren't watching it. So you're just kind of targeting over 50s who are watching in the 80s and have watched their whole lives. And then that's really about it. The current target audience is over 50s and smarks who love work rate. And then the minority of casual viewers who are still left. That's the current audience. Whereas with old wrestling, I look at old wrestling and think to myself, that targeted, obviously, males 18 to 49 primarily, and that kind of market, but it also targeted teenagers, and it was cool, and it was hip, and it was fresh, and what they were doing was trendy, and they had guys who, your Triple H, Shawn Michaels, Stone Cold Steve Austin, Rock, Undertaker, Booker T, Kane, Vince McMahon, Shane, all these guys who you turned on a segment involving them and there was a meaningful storyline. You wanted to see what they were doing. And I look at going back to Survivor Series 2002, just like how they do these shows. This is a very small example, but let's take, they were doing backstage segments. Shawn Michaels was being interviewed ahead of his World Heavyweight Championship Elimination Chamber match. He was being interviewed, he was all excited, he was about to talk, he said like two lines. And then we had a public service announcement from Randy Orton, like baby-faced Randy Orton, who's like, yeah, Randy Orton must have been about 20 at this stage, but Randy Orton's in a sling doing this classic just heel promo talking about how, look guys, I know you you really care about my rehabilitation, just letting you know I'm going well with my rehab, you know, the Sherry on the plane made sure to give me an extra pillow, and he's like winking at the camera, really just good corny heel tactics, corny heel stuff to, you know, interrupt the beloved babyface. Just good writing like that, puts over the young heel. We don't get to hear from Michaels, so he draws heel heat on Orton. Stuff like that. It's just, it's in the writing with pro wrestling. Pro wrestling, when the writing's correct, and the writing's really good, and the talent's there, it can be phenomenal. And that's why I miss old wrestling. The current wrestling, what you've been seeing for the last like 10 to 15 years, it isn't wrestling. It's like, what did Triple H describe it as? I was watching a Triple H interview the other day, and he described it, yeah, Triple H described, you know, wrestling when there isn't like that intense story to it as just people doing stunts. And really that's what wrestling is nowadays. It's people doing stunts and you care about like four wrestlers. That's what wrestling is nowadays. And you compare that to old wrestling with Survivor Series 2002 with Eric Bischoff introducing the Elimination Chamber. And that's the other point I want to make. Old wrestling had innovation. There was new stuff because everything hadn't been done already. Nowadays, basically everything's been done. Everything that's worth doing has been done. There's not like stuff which you can really do now that would get over. Like, because all, you know, all the fans who are left just hate on everything. For example, Raw Underground. It was something new. Was it perfect? God no. But there was a lot of good in that. But that got shut down because it was new. And nowadays, new isn't cool. Even though new should be cool. It's a weird mentality in the wrestling community. But anyway, point of this video, I miss old wrestling. I take it most of you do because, I don't know, the wrestling nowadays, people who still watch it are the really loyal, dedicated hardcores. But as far as the people in the mainstream and people, the casuals, who really love wrestling, but fall out of love for it and fall out of favor with it because of how it's been booked, I guess this statement applies too. So yeah, I miss old wrestling, all that kind of good stuff. Like, comment, subscribe, and drill. See ya.